is good, y'all? It's Duncan here back in another video, man. And I'm here to talk about just the fact that nothing can ever, like, weigh heavy on your mind once you realize that everything comes down to attention. Like, anything you want in life, anything that you don't want in your mind, it comes down to attention and perception of it. So, like, say, and it comes down to space. Say if you had, like, a girlfriend that you and ended the relationship, right? But you were hurt over it for a while. The only reason you're hurt over it is because your vessel. Fuck, this is what I wanted to talk about in the last video, man. It's the vessel. The vessel has the oxytocin and all these chemicals and fucking shit that creates emotion. That's the only reason why we experience the emotions that we think that is real. And so, like, I realize, man, if you were in a relationship for a long time, it's because you put a lot of attention into this bucket. Let's imagine a bucket. You put a lot of attention into the bucket. That's filling it up. Put a lot of time into the bucket. That's filling it up. You spent a lot of time in space with that person. It's filling it up. You got a lot of memories with that person in space. That's filling it up even fucking more. That's a lot. So it's just adding on, bro. That's the only reason that you care, bro. That's the only reason. But, like, it's the time and space, bro. And the gravity. That's all. That's like the secret to life, I think, bro. It's time, space, and gravity, man. Because the only reason that is weighing so fucking heavy on your mind is because it happened just recently. And the reason it's so big is because in your life, it was a big sphere. A big sphere. My nigga, what are we cooking here, man? We're cooking something nice. It was a big sphere. In the other spheres that compile and make up your life. So the relationship being a big sphere in your life, now once it's gone, it feels like something is missing. Like in the last video about the tarp, man. It feels like, except this time, when shit comes off the tarp, whatever, bro. We're not gonna use that one for this one. It's like the tarp though. So, since it just happened in space, this is it just happening, and then this is you. It's still gonna weigh heavy on you, bro, until you get further and further and further and further and further and further away from it in space. That's how all thought works, bro. You have to distance yourself from it in space and time. So, if you let the thought, like, keep on weighing in, it's never gonna leave, and it's not gonna be able to leave. That's why people, like, end up heartbroken for fucking so long, bro, for years and shit, because whenever they think about this person, they either, like, they start acting on it, like, doing things to cope with it because of that person. They, like, they dwell on the memories of that person. The fucking event of them leaving never actually left in fucking space, bro. It's still with them, bro. So it's like it just happened, basically. Wow. It's like it just happened. That's the only reason why. It's like it's a fucking attached to their head. Like a circle, man. Like, just connected. They need to we gotta just disconnect that shit, bro. And that's it. And then you just keep on walking. That's all it is, man. Bro, we're walking in a hall. There's so many experiences, man. You get to one experience as one sphere, bro. Once you experience it, walk away from it, man. Just keep on going. That's all it is. That's all it is, bro. That's all it is. That's how everything works in this matrix, bro. Everything. Love. Love. You need to keep on adding certain, you need to keep on adding good emotions and love emotions onto that person. More than you're adding bad emotions in time and space. And that is what connects y'all together, bro. Because if you have too many bad moments in time and space, they're gonna break up with you. But some people see you, this is how, bro, this is the fucking secret to everything, bro. Because we know, like, men know a lot of the women down here on earth, they like to play a lot of games, bro. So if you want to know how to, they like to play a lot of games. So if you want to keep them entertained, sometimes some people advise to cause trouble, bro. I mean, I wouldn't advise that, but some people advise that, bro. But wait, that's basically how you get anything in life. It's rapport. Everything is a rapport system, bro. Man, bro. Everything is a rapport system. The connections in life you get, it's the rapport, bro. How you make a person feel is everything that you to get in life. That's it. Nigga, you could be the best. Nigga, you could be the best, but if you come off like, if you make a mistake and the person takes it emotionally bad, that could ruin their entire image of you. Their image, their perspective of you, bro. When in reality, that's not even you. Like, but it just came off that way. It relies on a, you know. That's another thing, man. That's another thing that reminds me. This matrix, bro. It relies heavily, pretty much, basically, all off on appearance, man. Off first impressions a lot. It requires a lot on first impression, man. Like I said, man. If I was given, like, a lot of people might not take the shit I say as seriously because I'm not, like, a 50-year-old white man sitting in a suit and tie with hair not covering his face and with not glasses on. I mean, with glasses on. You know? But it's really about the soul. It's really about what the soul can give, bro. Like, there's so many vessels. I mean, there's so many illusions. It's an illusion, bro. At the same time, bro, we're not gonna act like we're not attracted to certain things, or whatever. You know what I mean? But video's getting a little long. Seems like we may be done with this one. So, I also wanted to talk a little about observation I made on marijuana. It seems as if whenever you gain, or no, not even that, but we've been using marijuana for so many years, right? Ever since Egypt, pretty sure. So why is it like that when people awaken, they think trying to say marijuana is bad, bro? Why do they start trying to say that? Anyways, when it comes to the attention and thought, bro, I notice like a lot of the brothers in the conscious side that I do see like on Instagram and stuff, like they're awakened, man, and they still smoke. So I'm not saying like I'm following them, but if they're all awakened, I'm awakened, we're doing fine. It can't be that bad. We're doing all this shit. You feel me? So, but the real thing, don't understand. Oh wait, no, we were talking about that. The thing. Whenever I get high, bro, it's like you don't pay attention to the thoughts that you would have had when you're sober, bro. It's like entering the med it's like entering meditation. It's like entering into a state of constant meditation. And I think that's like why the brothers that are conscious smoke, because when you're like down here, I don't know, sometimes it's good to be sober, and sometimes you do want to be sober, but then other times it's like, why would you, when being faded is just better? It's like just living better. That's all it is sometimes. At other times, sometimes you shouldn't be high, sometimes you just shouldn't be too high. But also, yeah, another thing, bro. I realized, like, I just thought about it a couple of days ago, bro. I'm pretty sure, like, I was destined for the Egyptian yoga path. I don't do Egyptian, I mean, Kemetic. I don't do Kemetic yoga yet. But I have done it. I'm probably not gonna start doing it consistently until just whenever, sometime after I graduate. But like, I thought it started in track in junior year, bro. But actually, like, before junior year, started in the summer when I had went to, like, before actually went out to, before I went to the hospital, I had started, like, journaling when I was faded. Like, I started, like, journaling and going on this self and not really self-improvement, but yeah, just self-improvement. Like, I just started wanting to improve my life, and I just started, like, sitting around smoking, bro. I was like 15, six, like 15, bro. 15, man. And then, yeah. Like, I realized, like, that when I would stretch. I realized that when I would stretch. Now, was it 16? It was 16. It was 16. Fuck, I don't even know. When I was, whatever age, I realized that when I would stretch, that it would, like, allow me to be higher, bro. Like, I would get higher when I would stretch. And that's connected to yoga, because when you do yoga, it's freeing the prana, and like when it frees the tension, that's freeing like blockage and freeing the prana, freeing energy. It's also blood flow, but it's energy too. So both of them allows you to like get higher. It's crazy because I don't even know why I started doing that, but I just found out about it, bro. Who knows? It could have been, I don't know. That's how I feel. I feel like it was just in my alignment, bro. Like my body just started doing it or something. I just started just deciding to stretch or something. It's not. Oh yeah. No, I wouldn't say started deciding to stretch, because I was working out. That's why. What I really meant is, and what I was thinking of, But even before, when this thought originally came into my head, before I even thought about making a video for it, I was like, what if the energy was meant to be freed at that time? And then that's what like started all of my awakening, bro. What the hell? Imagine if that would be crazy. That's interesting. But either way, man, I feel like that was in alignment. Even if it like didn't start the awakening by opening prana, I feel like it could have been. Cause I never heard of nobody talk about that, bro. Like when I told niggas about that, and if I told niggas about that smoke, bro, they probably would just look at me like, bro, no one's really doing that every time. And I'm like, I used to do it. I stopped like after a while, probably just 'cause I just fell out of it. But yeah. But that's the end of this one, and peace.